before we get on to this video, if you like what you see, make sure you support me on Patreon. Everything is very much appreciated. And also, if you want to request things for me to react to, movies, albums, you know, songs, definitely make sure you check me out on Streamlabs. Both of those links are in the description. And with that being said, much love, stay safe, and peace out. What's up, guys? Today I'm going to be checking out Helen Baylor. This one's titled Helen Baylor's Testimony, Praying Godmother, requested by Chubby Chuckle on Streamlabs. Big shout out to you. Haven't heard this one before, and I believe it's a live performance as well, which I have not seen. But yeah, that being said, let's go ahead and check it out. Clocking in at 9 minutes long. So yeah, let's check it out.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, we definitely turning that off. Oh,
you know, smart. I started in the church as a little girl, 7 years old, and grandmother used to take me to church back in Tulsa, Oklahoma, and I used to sing for the Lord, and I used to sing in the adult choir, and I loved the Lord with all my heart. By the time I was 9 years old, I was gung-ho, and my grandmother even said to me one day, she said, you know, baby, God's going to use you one day. And I didn't know what she meant, but I knew I liked the sound of God using me. By the time I was 11 years old, my mother and father and my five brothers and my little sister, we moved from Tulsa to California. My dad's job had transferred him out here, and by the time I was 12 years old, I found myself in the nightclubs in Los Angeles. My mom and dad used to go to the clubs on the weekends. They didn't know the Lord Jesus. And grandma wasn't around anymore, so we just quit going to church. I was in the nightclubs at 12 years old, and that was the worst place and the last place I needed to be. But I had a praying grandmother. By the time I was 13 years old, I had recorded my first single and began to open up for people like Stevie Wonder and Aretha Franklin, B.B. King, and Bill Cosby. I remember opening up for him one time, and things began to happen. Hallelujah. Things began to happen all around me. The devil had a trap set. He was going to set me up, because see, I liked it. I liked the money. I was making a lot of money, and I liked the glamour, and I liked the applause, because that said, I love you. We all want to be loved. Hallelujah. I didn't know that Jesus loved me. I didn't know a thing. When I was 16 years old, I had had a baby out of wedlock, and by the time I was 17 years old, I left home and joined the cast of Hair, and I began to travel all across the country. I was making more money than my mom and dad put together by then, and things were looking pretty good. Then I was introduced to marijuana. Devil had a trap set. Next thing I know, it was pills to get up in the morning and pills to go to bed at night. Then it was the alcohol, and then I became very promiscuous and ran around with a lot of people I had no business being with. And one day I was introduced to cocaine, and I know that all drugs are a spirit, but this cocaine became my best friend. And I began to hang out with the devil, and I did everything that I was big and bad enough to do. And I'm not glorifying him, I'm just letting him know that I don't belong to you. Hallelujah. I've been set free. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I went on for about 12 years of my life, and I traveled with people, and I worked with Chaka Khan and Rufus, and I worked with Captain and Tennille and all the people in the studios, and I was good at my job, and I was quick, and I could demand double, triple scale, and I went to work, and I was high every day.
Wait, she say, what, she was a singer? I'm assuming so, right? Probably.
Studios, and I was good at my job and I was quick and I could demand double, triple scale, and I went to work and I was high every day.
I don't know if she said it. She's a singer, or she was a singer for them, right? Just curious. Answer or tell me in the comments.
The devil was
I'm assuming
trying
so.
To kill
me. I don't really know if she's a producer.
I had a praying grandmother, never turn her back. Hallelujah. One time when I was in Houston, Texas, I met a man there and I was getting ready to go on the road with Chaka Khan, and there was a group going on the road with us, Heatwave, and they had a man working with them and he was doing their lights, and I didn't know this, but I met him on the road and he was a nice guy and you never would know it to look at him, but he was also, not only was a light director, but he was a cocaine dealer. See, devil knows how to really do. So we began to be friends and we began to date, and I began to get all the cocaine I wanted for free. How many of you know it wasn't for free? But we came home, me and this young man, and we began to live together, and he was still selling drugs, and I began to make drops for him. I was dropping off cocaine and making a lot of foolish turns in my life, and my life began to do this spiral, downward spiral. I was going to hell. Then I began to watch Christian television. I began to watch Dr. Frederick Casey Price. Hallelujah. No matter what time we went to bed on Saturday night, whether it was 3:30, 4:30 in the morning, somehow our eyes popped open at 8:30. Evidence. And I have to be honest with you, I used to sit there with my pre-rolled joints from the night before, and I used to fire up a joint and watch Dr. Price. And I used to kind of, you know, Dr. Price, you know how I am. I used to kind of make fun of Dr. Price. I said, well, just look at him, talk about faith come by hearing. And hearing by the word of God. But faith came. Hallelujah, go on and praise him tonight. Hallelujah. He's worthy. Yes, he is. For about 2 years, I watched Christian television. I was in and out, and I bought a Bible, and I would throw away all of the paraphernalia to smoke crack with and the smoke-free base, and we used to make it and make our own. I threw it all in the trash, and then I'd go get it again, and we'd get high. And one night as I was getting loaded, I began to pass out. And my head hit the wall. Boom! And I began to slide down the wall. And as I came to, all of my bodily fluids were doing their own thing and I was dying. But I had a praying grandmother. And I knew enough to call on the name of Jesus. It wasn't a couple of days later that I was watching Christian television. And Grandma tells me she was laying on her face during this time and she had been fasting for 2 weeks and just calling on the name of Jesus. Save my granddaughter. Save my granddaughter, Jesus. I watched Christian TV one night and it was as if God himself said, that's enough. And he rebuked the devil from me long enough for me to make an intelligent decision. And I said, Jesus, if you'll turn me back, I want to come home if you'll take me. And I said, Jesus, I know you're real. If you'll just take all of this away from me, take all of the drugs, take them away, I'm tired. And I want you to know that instantly I was set free. Instantly I was delivered. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This was on a Friday night. And I want you to know that not only did God save and deliver me and set me free, but he saved that drug dealer, and he's my husband tonight, James Taylor.
Okay, that's a twist I was not expecting. Okay, so that was basically just, okay, I didn't know it was going to be like a, like I'm, you know, in church, first pew. You know, I thought it was going to be a, like a song or something, but that was definitely interesting. I enjoyed that. Very gripping story, moving story. And yeah, that was cool. I really enjoyed watching that and listening to that. Helen Baylor's testimony, praying grandmother. Yeah, that was really nice. Wait, do I know who Helen Baylor is? I feel like I recognize the last name, but I'm not 100% sure. I think I know her, who she is. I don't know. I'm going to have to do a little research on her. But yeah, like I said, that was a very, very gripping and, you know, moving story that she delivered. And I think there's definitely a lot that, you know, people can take away from this, you know, positively. And, you know, and just hearing how somebody can turn their life around through, you know, Christianity, spirituality, and just, you know, asking for forgiveness and whatnot. And I'm gonna keep it a buck. I'm not, like, I haven't been to church in a couple years, give or take. But I am, you know, I still consider myself a very spiritual person. I've been trying to read the Bible every day, but I'm trying to get back into it because I started it and then I kind of dropped it off, and now I'm trying to get back into it, like a page a day. So I'm trying to do that, and why am I saying this? I don't know. But yeah, I've been trying to do that more. I've been trying to pray more. I do it for the most part every time I wake up, but I've been trying to do it before I go to sleep as well. And yeah, just trying to get more into that, you know, into that side of things, because I never really read the Bible or anything like that. But yeah, I've been trying to do that. I'm still kind of falling away from it because, like, I don't know, it's just so, I'm not really a big fan of, like, the reading of it, you know, like, the way it's, you know, to be read. Like, it's like, hast thou cast thy side away from, like, jeez, man. And then all the begat, this person begat Mikhail begat Esau begat, like, jeez, man, holy smokes. But yeah, you know, trying to work my way through it, but I don't know why I just said that. I don't know, I guess for because of lack of anything else to say. But yeah, definitely enjoyed listening to that, and if you guys enjoyed the reaction, make sure you smack the like button, subscribe if you're new. That being said, much love, stay safe, and peace out. Also, I want to add on, when I said I haven't been to church in a couple years, I mean physically, you know, well, I mean, same thing, but I have been watching it, you know, online here and there, not a whole lot, like, not every Sunday, but I've been, you know, watching it more and more, you know, every Sunday, as opposed to, you know, how I used to. I just used to skip it all together. But yeah, I have been watching it more and more, and recently my mom has been, you know, kind of forcing me to watch it with her. So yeah, just wanted to add that on top. But yeah, peace out.